topic, synchronous machines. Synchronous machines include synchronous generators and synchronous motors. Synchronous machines include synchronous generators and synchronous motors. Okay. Synchronous generators are also known as AC generators or alternators. Synchronous generators are also known as AC generators or alternators. Alternators are used to generate electrical energy in power plants. AC generators are used to generate electrical energy in power plants. The prime movers are usually steam turbines in the case of high speed machine and hydraulic turbines in the case of low speed machine. So synchronous machines are classified into synchronous motors and synchronous generators. First of all, we are discussing about synchronous generators or alternators. Okay, alternators are used to generate electrical energy. Alternators are used to generate electrical energy in power plants. The prime movers are usually steam turbines in the case of high speed machines, that is in the case of thermal power plants and nuclear power plants. In the case of thermal power plants and nuclear power plants, we are using these type of alternators whose prime movers are steam turbines. Okay, in the case of thermal power plant and nuclear power plant, the prime movers of the alternators are usually steam turbines. In the case of low speed machines, that means in the case of hydroelectric power plants, we are using low speed machine whose prime movers are hydraulic turbines. Once again, synchronous machines are classified into synchronous motors and synchronous generators. Synchronous generators are also known as alternators. Alternators are used to generate electrical energy in power plants. The prime movers are usually steam turbines in the case of high speed machines. Example, thermal power plants and nuclear power plants. That means in thermal power plants and nuclear power plants, we are using high speed machines or high speed alternators whose prime movers are usually steam turbines. In hydroelectric power plants, we are using low speed alternators whose prime movers are hydraulic turbine. Next, synchronous motors. If a synchronous machine operates as a motor, so two types of synchronous machines are there: synchronous motors and synchronous generators. Synchronous generators means alternators. Alternators, low speed alternators, high speed alternators. High speed alternators turbines are steam turbines or steam turbines, whereas low speed alternators, which are used in hydroelectric power plants, whose turbines are hydraulic turbines. Then next one, synchronous motors. If a synchronous machine operates as a motor, it is called a synchronous motor. If a synchronous machine operates as a generator, it is called a synchronous generator. If a synchronous machine operates as a motor, it is called a synchronous motor. That means it is a constant speed motor. Synchronous motor is a constant speed motor. It runs either at a synchronous speed or not at all. Construction. Synchronous machines essentially consist of two parts, namely stator and rotor. Stator is the stationary part which consists of a three-phase winding or armature winding. The armature is built up of laminations of silicon steel in order to reduce eddy current loss and hysteresis loss. The slots are placed on the periphery of the armature. To the house armature windings, and rotor is the rotating part. The field windings kept on the rotor and is excited with the DC supply. Okay, so synchronous machines essentially consist of two parts, stator and rotor. Stator consists of armature winding and rotor consists of field winding. In both cases, whether it is synchronous motor or synchronous generator, we have to excite the field winding. Okay, if a synchronous machine acts as a generator, it is known as synchronous generator or alternator. If it is a motor, it is known as synchronous motor. Synchronous motor is a constant speed motor. A synchronous machine has two parts. Machine means edu avato, motor agan, generator agan. A synchronous machine has two parts, stator and rotor. Stator consists of armature winding and rotor consists of field winding. Principle of operation of an alternator. An alternator is a machine which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. An Alternator is a machine which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. The main parts are stator and rotor. Stator consists of armature winding and rotor consists of field winding which should be excited by a DC supply. An alternator operates according to Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. When the field winding is excited from a DC supply, it can create flux. That flux passes through the air gap and cuts the armature winding, and an EMF is induced in the armature according to Faraday's first law of electromagnetic induction. Okay, so field winding is excited from DC supply, then it can create a flux. That flux passes through the armature winding, and an EMF is induced in the armature according to Faraday's first law of electromagnetic induction. So that is the working of an alternator. So we are discussing about synchronous machines. Synchronous machines are classified into two: synchronous generators and synchronous motors. Whether it is synchronous generator and synchronous motor, it has two parts, stator and rotor. Stator consists of armature winding and rotor consists of field winding. When the field winding is excited from DC supply, it can create a flux. That flux passes through the air gap and cuts the armature winding, and an EMF is induced in the armature according to Faraday's first law of electromagnetic induction. Then why are we providing this armature winding in the stationary part? Advantages of keeping the armature winding stationary. Advantages of keeping the armature winding stationary and field in the rotor. We are keeping the armature winding in the stationary part of the synchronous machine and field is in the rotating part. There are so many advantages for that. Advantages of keeping the armature stationary and field is in rotating system. Synchronous generators or alternators are normally constructed with a stationary armature. Synchronous generators or alternators are normally constructed with a stationary armature and rotating field system. Advantages of stationary armature are: it is easy to insulate the stationary armature than that of a rotating armature. It is easy to insulate. This output current can be directly taken from the fixed armature terminals without passing through the slip rings and brushes. The output current can be directly taken from the fixed armature terminals without passing through the slip rings and brushes. Armature winding can be cooled more easily because of the presence of very large stator with many air passages or cooling ducts or cooling purpose. Okay, it can be easily cooled. A stationary armature can be easily cooled. It is easy to wind a stationary armature. Rotating part il ikkunnakal stationary part il ikkunna or armature ne wind cheyanayittu easy aanu. It is easy to wind a stationary armature. First point, advantages of keeping the armature winding stationary. Output current can be directly taken from the fixed armature. It is very easy to collect the armature current from a stationary part. It is very easy to collect the armature current from a stationary part. Second advantage, comparing to a rotating part, it is very easy to collect the armature current from the stationary part. Second advantage, armature winding can be cooled very easily in a stationary armature. A stationary armature can be cooled easily than that of a rotating armature. Appo armature rotating part ilanengil wind cheyan buddhimuttana, ivda wind cheyan easy aanu, insulate cheyan easy aanu, cooling purpose easy aanu, output current easy aayittu collect cheyam. Okay, then fourth point, due to robust construction, slip rings are connected to low voltage DC field circuit which can therefore be easily insulated. We are keeping the low weight winding or heavy winding is armature winding which is in the stationary part, and low weight winding is field winding which is in the stationary part. Okay, it is necessary to excite the field winding, so we can give the DC supply to the field winding through slip rings and brushes. Then only two slip rings and brushes are needed. Suppose we are keeping the armature winding is in rotor and field winding is, we are keeping the armature winding is in rotor. Four slip rings are needed to collect the armature current from the rotor. To give current and to take current from a rotating part, there are slip rings and brushes are necessary. Here, the heavy winding is armature winding in which AC voltage is induced. That is in the stationary part from which we can collect the AC. We can collect the voltage easily. But our field winding is in rotor. It is necessary to excite the field winding. So we have to give DC supply to the field winding through slip rings and brushes. But only two slip rings and brushes are needed. Though thirichayirunnengil, definitely we have to use four slip rings and brushes to collect AC voltage from the armature. To collect AC voltage from the armature, we have to use four slip rings and brushes. But in the case of rotating field system, only two slip rings are needed to excite the field system. Okay, fifth point, armature winding can be more easily braced to prevent any deformation which could be developed by the mechanical stresses due to short circuits. It is easy to wind a stationary armature, I told earlier. Then low cost and low maintenance. Low cost and low maintenance. The armature winding can be easily braced to prevent any deformation which could be developed by the mechanical stresses due to short circuit. So these are the advantages of keeping the armature winding stationary. These are the advantages of keeping the armature winding stationary. Okay, so synchronous machine consists of synchronous generators and synchronous motors. Whether it is synchronous generator or synchronous motor, two parts, stator and rotor. Stator consists of armature winding and rotor consists of field winding. There are so many advantages for keeping the armature winding stationary that we are discussing. We have discussed all those points just now. Okay, I think this topic is very clear. If a synchronous machine operates as a generator, it is known as synchronous generator. If a synchronous machine operates as a motor, it is known as synchronous motor.